there's a real source, yes, there are real sources. However, for safety reasons, we don't have a copyright general, but they could be made into what we call sharks with a proper coverage. If there weren't real sharks, they would never take that blow on blow continuously the way they get used week in, week out. It looks like the greater forces of Parliament have now decimated the Scots. More than that, decimated is only 1 in 10. I think it's a lot worse than that. We've got drummers down. They were up and asking us. This is obviously Cromwell's very annoyed with the King. He's determined that this is going to be the final battle that he can possibly make it. Heels is tired of war as the rest of the country. And it looks at least on the right flank for Cromwell that they have been victorious. There are still pockets of royalists, but I think that they are deciding it's time to quit the field while they've still got their lives, if not their honour. But they've been allowed to keep their colours, so they've kept their dignity. It's looking to me like all of a sudden it's ended, that Cromwell has taken the day, and if that is the case, the 3rd of September 1651, and England had almost its final the Civil War. There was a major insurrection some 20 years further on from the war, but the big Civil War ended this day. 360 years ago. I'm very close to this spot. So, as the royalists leave the field, pursued by Parliament,
clear, dry them up clear, so wet.
Match out.
So, ladies and gentlemen, we have a tradition in the seal mark that our dead brethren have a home to go to. And so if you have appreciated what they've done for us today, if you can give them a round of applause, that's usually a signal you can get up now, boys. Thank you very much. I would like to leave you with a real piece of history. Here is the final comment from the Reverend Hugh Thomas.
That's why we have the bottles to use down the barrel.